Well, the simplest and most straightforward check you can do on any hydraulic braking system is to check the level of brake fluid in the reservoir of the brake master cylinder, which is that chap down there, usually found in that sort of position, in the engine well, just on the other side of where the brake pedal comes through, hardly surprisingly. Very easy job to do, as most of them these days are made of transparent material, and I just happen to have brought another one so that you can see it a bit more clearly. As you will see, two lines, maximum and minimum. Not surprisingly, the object of the exercise is to make sure that the fluid is up to the maximum mark and never falls below the minimum mark. Remember too, when topping it up, that many modern cars have dual circuit braking. You can see the split in this reservoir there. If I take the top off, you'll see that this master cylinder controls both braking circuits, so do remember to top up both sides. A very good safety point there. Equally remember not to put too much brake fluid in and let it flow over the top and onto the paintwork, because brake fluid is one of the best strippers of cellulose paint known to man. Equally, never let it fall below the minimum mark on any account, because all that will happen then is that when you depress the brake, the cylinder here will fill with air and you won't be able to stop. What sort of brake fluid to use? Well, you'll find the correct specification, and the correct specification is important in your vehicle's handbook. And remember too that as brake fluid gets old, it absorbs moisture, and that is why it is a very good safety point to change all the brake fluid in the entire system at least every 2 or 3 years. Well, to carry out any checks or possible adjustments down at the brakes themselves, obviously you've got to raise the car up off the ground. How to do this? Choose a piece of firm, level ground and engage reverse gear, or park if you've got a car with an automatic gearbox, and away you go. But one very important safety tip: it is very, very unwise to start crawling around underneath a car if it is just supported by its own jack. You really do need an effective additional means of support. And this is the very best sort. This is an axle stand. Works just like that, and it's very secure. In fact, we've got one underneath the car there. Now, if you're going to use one of these, put it somewhere suitable. Put it underneath a body shell box section, or as here, underneath a cross member. If you put this thing underneath the sump or underneath the floor pan, which is worst of all, and then lower away, you'll find that this will start working its way up through the floor, and that's expensive. Well, first of all, check the condition of the rubber brake hoses, and if there's any sign of leaking at one of the unions, change them. And do the same too if they look obviously perished or are cracking up. Examine the metal brake pipes, which you'll find clipped to the underside of the car. Here you're looking out for bad corrosion, usually caused by road salt during the winter. Check the unions for weeping brake fluid, particularly where they join the drum brake's back plate, taking fluid to the hydraulic wheel cylinder. Here we've got two for each front drum brake. Any leaking there? And go to a garage. If you have drum brakes at the front, you'll usually have a pair of adjusters like these. Now, they need periodic tightening up to take up the slack, as it were, as the brake lining material wears down. Each adjuster works something called a snail cam, like this, and that pushes the back of the brake shoe towards the inside of the drum, gradually tightening the whole thing up. To do this, you need to use a proper brake adjuster spanner, which will set you back about 75 pence or so. Not an open-ended spanner, and never pliers, because you can all too easily round all the corners off the adjuster, which leads to big problems. So how do you actually go about adjusting drum brakes? Well, with the right spanner, find the adjuster behind and tighten up until you really feel resistance, which means that the brake lining is pushing out there on the brake drum. Then begin to slacken off until the wheel will revolve without any sign of rubbing. And Bob's your uncle. May well be, of course, that your car has disc brakes at the front, in which case you're lucky because they're self-adjusting. As the pads wear down, so they automatically keep the correct distance away from the disc, thus avoiding any sort of adjustment there. But you've still got to make the usual checks, look out for leaks and for corrosion in the hoses and the brake pipe unions. And, most importantly, you must make sure that there is at least 3/16 of an inch of pad material on either side of the disc. Once it gets down to the 3/16 mark, that's the time to go back to your garage and ask them to slip in a new set of disc pads. Most cars still have drum brakes at the rear, and they're frequently self-adjusting, so you don't have to bother with adjustments. What you do have to do, though, is to go around them regularly and check for the usual leaks in pipework and corrosion, that sort of thing. The handbrake is invariably cable-operated, and you can adjust it either on the brake lever itself inside the car or somewhere underneath the car. But if you do want to take up the slack in the handbrake cable, remember this: you must do it with the rear wheels on the ground, which means that the rear springs will both be quite level, and don't try and do it with the handbrake on. It must be off. And if you're really keen, you also lubricate the cable itself wherever it turns any corners, or where there are any mechanical joints, such as these clevis pin joints, where the handbrake goes into the back of the back plate, and for that you use a drop or two of ordinary engine oil. Well, those are the regular checks, but what about the troubles? Like if the pedal feels very spongy. Well, that usually means there's air in the system. The system has to be bled, and for most of us, that's a garage job. Or if the brakes still work well, but you have to push the pedal a long way down, there's a tremendous amount of travel. That means the brakes need adjusting, so adjust them. Or if the brakes still work well, but they judder through the pedal. There's two possible causes for that. Either the linings or pads are on the way out, in which case replace them, or they're covered in oil, in which case replace them. Look after your brakes and they'll look after you.